everyone, welcome to the video series of the subject Object Oriented Programming using Java. Myself Hemali Shah, I am working as an assistant professor in LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Now in this video lecture I am going to cover the topic methods in Java. This particular topic is a part of unit number 2, classes, objects and methods. So let's learn about the method. So what is method and what is function? This is the synonyms of method, function, right? This you have already done inside this C also, and from the first day, from the first program, you are already making the function. What is it? It is public static void main. The main is basically a function, right? So you are already knowing this is the function, but what, how to create user defined function and how to call this function that you have created and when to create this function. So let's understand this whole the things. So this particular methods can be used to define reusable code, and it actually organize and simplify your code that you have developed to build your application logic, right? Now whenever a class method typically contains its the code that actually manipulates the object states. So whatever data members you are making inside the class and the methods that you are making inside the class, the method actually maintains the state, that means data members of the class. This all the methods actually follow some syntax, and the syntax is like this. This rectangle indicates rectangle braces indicates optional thing. Modifiers, that means you can add public, static, then final, this all are the modifiers, private, protected, that are access modifiers, static, final, synchronized, abstract, these are also modifiers. So you can write here any modifiers before declaring the return type. The important and requirement things to declare a method is return type is compulsory in Java, method name is compulsory in Java, and the parameter are optional. If you want to pass the parameter to your function, you have to write inside the brackets, rounded brackets, and after declaring your method, you have to give the body of the method to all the non-abstract function. Inside the body, we are writing the logic of this particular method, or we can say the logic of the function that actually we want to provide by using this particular method. So this is the particular syntax, right? Now let's take an example of this method. Here this void display is a method having no argument, and the return type I am specifying as a void. And the body of the body of this display function, you can write the statements to write something on the console. Such a statement you can write as a body part of this display function. This add marks having one parameterized integer a parameter argument kind of function, single argument that we have to pass when we call this particular function. The return type of this function is void. You can write the statements inside the body part of this function. You can declare the local variable also inside this function. Here integer total is a local variable, and you can use the arguments argument variable inside this. This a you can use inside the body of this function, that a having the scope within the add marks function only. You can declare the return type of this function also. This getName actually having the return type string, and that is no argument, right? And whenever you are declaring the return type to your function, you have to return something inside the body of this function. So keep in mind, you have the return type to your function and parameter to your function. Based on this, you have four kinds of function you can declare as per your application requirement. As per the return type, you can go for the no return type. That means you have to go for the void as a return type to your function. with return type function. So when with return type, you can write return type to your function as a built-in data type, and you can use the class as a return type of your function also. Whenever you are using built-in data types as a return type to your function actually returns by value. It will become return by value function. If you are using this class as a return type to your function, at that time actually you are returning by reference. That will become your returning by reference, right? So based on return type, no return type, with return type you have again two things, return by value and return by reference also. Now based on parameter, you can declare the parameter or you cannot declare the parameter based on requirement of your application logic, with parameterized function and with without parameterized function. So based on parameter, you have again two category. If you have no return, no parameter, then you just need to keep a blank brackets. If you have the parameters, then parameter can be built-in data types or it can be a class data types. If you are specifying built-in data types like integer, float, double as a parameter to your function, that will become a call by value function. And if you are using the class as a parameter to your function, that will become your pass by or call by reference function, right? So keep in mind these things. And whenever you are declaring some variable inside the function declaration, that actually called as a parameter, that parameter is called as a formal parameters. And whenever you are invoking some function, and if you are using some variable at the time of function call, that variable is actually called as a actual variable. So formal variable here in this code, this small a, integer small a inside this add marks function is a formal variable to this add marks function. And this formal variable you can use only within the function, right? So this all about the methods, the terminologies that we will use inside this function. Now more about this function. Method may contain the local declaration as well as executable statements. The variable declaration locally can only be used locally. The return type of a method indicates the type of value that actually method sends back to the calling location. A method that does not return a value such as main has a void return type. Right, so you have to write at least void when you don't want to return anything from the function. Now the return statement specifies the value that will be returned to the actual calling location, and the expression must confirm the return type whenever you are writing the return type inside the body part of the method. Now more about this. The method can be defined to accept zero or more parameters. Each parameter in the parameter list is specified by the type and name. The parameter in the method defines are called as a formal parameter, that I have already told you. And the values that you are passed to the method when it is involved, or we can say the call, are actually called as a actual parameters, right? Now how to call, or we can say the invoke, the instance method or functions. The instance method means you must have the object to call that particular method, or we can say the non-static method are called as a instance method, right? So this instance method are actually accessed only by creating object of the class. So you must have the object, then with the object you have to use the dot operator. Then you should use the function name and then pass the argument that is same as the function that you have defined inside the class. For our example, if S1 is the object of some student class and this displays a function in a student class, and you can call this particular function by using the object S1.display, display having no arguments, so we are not passing the parameter. This setName function have a string as a parameter. So to call this setName function, you have the object S1, then use the dot. set name is a function name and pass the argument, because the string is a parameter to this set name function. That's why, such that you can invoke this particular function by using the object, right? Now let's do this particular example of methods in our same core student class, having this many data members: name, gender, age, standard, and marks. Now till now we have created the objects and assigns the value to this particular properties. We have the two object, Ram and Sita object, and we have assigned this all the properties by using the statements in a public static void main. Now you can remove this repeated code by making some function. You have to declare one function and create the one function display to remove the repeated code of the display function. You have to we will create one more function, set detail function, that actually sets the data inside the property of the current object, that sets the name, gender, age, standard, marks, value to the current object, right? So let's do this particular thing and remove the repeated code in our example, in the current example. So here I'm going to open this Notepad++ and having the same code over here. So let's try, let's begin the code. See, inside this particular code you have this repeated code. See here, this side S1 name, Ram, gender, age, standard, this all having the value, right? Now can we make this remove this repeated code from the right? So for that we are making one function, void set detail function, that actually sets this all the values to the object, right? So here what we should put over here, so I want to do to set the data to this particular object. So let's copy the statements and paste it over here to copy this data, right? Now instead of S1 object, we have the current object. You can use the these, or you can directly use the data members and assign this all the values. Now what should be the values? It should be, is it static? And here what it should be, Ram, boy, like this, or we should declare a variable. We should have the variable like string, and then second one is gender. That's why this gender having the string. So string, then gender, G, I'm taking G as a variable name, integer, age, for age I'm taking AG, then to receive the gender, then integer S, instead of comma, semicolon, there is a comma, right? There is no semicolon over here. Then integer, int, s, standard, and for the marks I'm again declaring integer m, right? Now just paste this n to the name property. So here this name should be same as the n that is received inside it, right? So this here n I'm going to copy into name property. Then for the gender, I am having the formal parameter name is g, so here I am pasting this g to gender. Then age, having the ag variable, I'm passing over here. Standard having st. Then marks having the formal variable is m. So you can write it over here. So this function will set all the data to the current object, and this data we will pass at the time of function call, right? And this is the return type of this function is a void. That's why we should not write here any return statement, or if you want to write, then you can write only return. If you are not going to write return, then also it is fine, because here this return type is void, right? So by default return statement is available. When function completes, it automatically returns to the calling statement, right? Now how to call this function? So move inside your main and you have this s1 object, then by using this s1 object call this function setDetail, right? Now what I want to set inside this s1 object, I want to set the name property as a Ram, then this second property gender as a boy, as a string. So I have to pass this boy over here as a string parameter. Now next parameter is a age. Age is 12, that I'm going to pass over here, right? So here I should pass 12. Then the next variable is age. This age I am passing as a 8 as a value, and this marks 12 I am passing over here. Now you can remove this particular code from here, because now this function will perform this particular statement execution and you will get the same answer. Now you can do the same thing with the s2 object also. So for that, call this particular function setDetail to this s2 object, s2 dot setDetail is a function name, setDetail, right? And we are passing the parameter to the name is equals to Sita. The name of s2 object is Sita, so you can pass here Sita as a value of this name property of this s2 object. Then Sita is a girl, so you have to pass gender as a girl. Then this age value is 5 for this s2 object. The standard value is 1 for this s2 object, and this marks value as a 15 to this particular s2 object, right? And you can remove this particular statements from here. Now likewise, you can remove this display statements from this main by making the display function also, right? Here I am making this class as a student taste use of methods, right? And see here, this is the code to display the object 1, to display the object 2 property, to display, and then I am writing that code that generates this marks. Now let's open the command prompt and compile it. Java C student test using function dot java. What is the error? Let me correct it in the program. There is a semicolon expected at 26 number line. So move in the 26 number line. Where is the mistake? So correct it and save it now. Right? I corrected at st, then semicolon, remove the semicolon and make the one comma. Now run this program, compile, recompile and run. See here we are getting the output and we are setting the data by using this setDetail function, right? So this s1 object having this all the values and s2 objects also having the same value. Now this, see this, we are getting the output from this display statements. You can also remove this display statement functions, display statements from this public static void main, and you can make one function void display over here like this, void display that actually display the properties of the object, and put this all the statements over here. This system.out.println, instead of object 1 you can write this only object also, and instead of s1 you just wants to print the property of current object. This all are the class instance variables, so you can directly use this name, gender, age, standard marks over here, because this all are the class instance property, right? This all the class instance variable you can directly use inside the function which are available in the same class. So in the setDetail function also we are using this all the data members, as well as in the display function also we can use this particular data members. Now remove this first line because I just want to print the detail, name, gender, age, standard from this display function, right? So likewise, you can identify the functionality of some function and you can make the statements to prepare the logic of the function. Now let's call these functions and just remove this all the lines from here, because now this is the code that we can execute by calling the function s1.display function. Call this display function By using S1 object, it always prints the name, gender, age, standard and marks property of this S1 object, because the current object is S1, that's why. And put the semicolon to call this particular function. S1 is my current object. So by using the object, you can call this display function. So please clear the syntax by using the object name S1, then dot, then use the function name. Like this, you can call this function by using S2 object also. So remove the repeated line and put this S2 dot display statement over here to call this display function with the object S2, right? So here again you can remove this repeated code. What statement will come here? This S1 dot display, because S1 marks is greater. Now in the else portion, the S2 object having the large marks or greater marks. So this S2 dot display, you can keep it over here. There is a one statement error, semicolon is missing at the display. So let me correct first. Let me try to compile. Display, then semicolon I have to make over here is S1 dot display, then semicolon, right? Now recompile it, you will get the output, and execute that you will get this output. See, this all the display function I am calling, and it actually display this all the things, right? In the previous example, we have done this thing by using the without using the function. You can see how many number of lines was in the previous example. Very large number of code you require if you are not making the function. So this actually, this function basically used to reduce the repeated code, and you can make the function to execute the repeated code, right? So by making the function, you can remove this particular repeated code over here, right? Just think about here only the two object we have created. If you have more than two objects, then what will be the length of the code, right? It will be very large. So here you can reuse the functionality with any object, right? With any object, and you can use with any object. You just need to change the object name whenever you want to use this particular function. At that time, you just need to change the object. So by using that current object here, it uses the S1 object. Whenever I'm using the S2 object, it actually uses the properties of this S2 object, not S1 object, right? So this compiler basically searches the current instance, and actually it uses the properties from the current instance only. Whenever you are using S1, it actually sets the details only in the S1 object, and whenever you are calling the display function, based on the current object, it actually retrieves the value. So current object is very important thing, because inside the function you are using only the class instance variable name, which is the class instance variable names are very common to S1 and S2. But because of this current instance variable, this compiler will identify from where I should access the name property, gender property, standard property and marks property, right? Right. So this all about this methods. Hope you people are clear with this method. So based on the practical and application logic requirement, you should create the function. You should create the parameter to your function, and you should create the return type of your function. So what is your application logic requirement? You should create your function. So hope you people are clear with all the concept of this methods. So create this all the things in your example, and try to understand what is method, how to define the method, and how to call the method by using the object. So do it with yourself. So here I'm going to end this particular session now. Thank you for watching this particular video. Thank you all of you.